We are not always so lucky to have all the data. Sometimes the data is blank. Sometimes it's not available or not applicable, and you don't want to have in your calculation empty cell calculated to a zero, because zero, it's not the same as blank. You don't want to get a value error or div by zero error or some other error, because if you're using this calculation somewhere else, then guess what? You're getting more errors. So I'm going to show you three different ways to calculate when you have a blank cell to actually produce a blank, not a zero, not an error, but actually a blank. So I have a sample Google Sheet here with items in one column, then units for each of the items, how many we have, then price per item, and then I calculate total. And maybe this information also is flowing into some other calculations farther in my analysis. So I have situation for item 5 when I don't have that information. Maybe I didn't get there yet. Maybe I'm still waiting for information. It's not available at this moment, but I know I will have it eventually. So in the formula currently, because I have an empty cell here, it's actually producing a zero calculation, but zero, it's not the same as blank. And if I'm using this for some kind of averaging or anything like that, that's going to be skewing our analysis. That's not what I want. Now, if I wanted to try the Excel formula, if blank, saying, if this cell is blank, do leave it blank. Otherwise, do the calculation, take the units and multiply by price. But that doesn't work because in Google Sheet, there is no such formula. In Google Sheet, you actually have a IFBLANK formula, which is a true or false check, basically. So if a cell is blank, it will return a true. Otherwise, it will return a false. So I will show you how to incorporate that, but I'll show you two different ways, which I feel are simpler to resolve this issue that we have. So the first way to do it is by using the not sign, which is basically less than or more than signs together, which produces not calculation. So we start with equal if. Now I'm going to say if this cell is not blank by just putting those less than or more than sign to produce a not. And now I'm just putting quotation mark, no space, just quotation mark next to each other. Then perform the calculation. Otherwise, do what? Leave it blank. So I can use this formula. Now the second way to do it is a bit of a spin on this formula by using it differently by saying, if the cell is blank, leave it blank. Otherwise, do the calculation. So if our units equal to blank, again, I'll put the quotation mark, no spacing, because if you put a space there, you'll be looking for a space. Then put a blank cell. Otherwise, perform the calculation. Right there. So you see, it's producing the same calculation. So when there is a number, it produces the calculation. Otherwise, if it's a blank, leaves it blank. And the third one is what we talked about by using the IFBLANK formula. So if I just use the IFBLANK formula, like so, and actually you can click that question mark and learn more to learn about the formula. And it does what I just mentioned before, checks whether the reference cell is empty and returns true or false. In our situation, we want to do B2, and then if I enter, it creates true or false, which is not very helpful right at this point because I need an actual number, and if I just do this, I can't copy it over because it messes up my calculation, but I can use it in my formula. Just leave that IFBLANK formula there, and I'm going to start with if and put parentheses. So now, if the IFBLANK cell is true, it's empty, by default it's true, then leave it empty. And I can just leave an empty space, but putting the other comma right away. Otherwise, perform the calculation, take unit times price. And you see it works. I can just copy it over and it does work. So now you learn three different ways of solving the problem when you have a blank cell and producing a blank instead of having a zero, which is not the same, or an error, which can also lead to other errors if using this calculation somewhere else. So thanks so much for watching.